Y'all know what the fuck going on. Royal Life Productions in this motherfucker.
Wait a second, wait a minute. Don't compare me to them other niggas. Desert Eagle, Smith & Wesson. I'm about to go to war, gone pledge allegiance. Where the real friends at when you really need them? When I was locked up in the county, I ain't even see them. About my lonely. What happened to the bitches and the party? 100 bottles, that was every weekend. Bitches pile up in my crib like a coliseum. At the 3 a.m., you know we getting freaky. Hella one-night stands, bitches catching feelings. Tired of fake loving. Fake Hollywood ain't about shit. Fake gang banging and claiming to pop shit. Fake titties and cocaine in their nostrils. Stop it.
3-4 years now. Started when I was about like 17. Shit, like, I just didn't want to stop it, you know what I'm saying? And I just seen, like, what everybody else was doing. And honestly, I just seen, like, a different way. And I just, it's something I like to do. Like, being from Arizona, it's all hot. And I stay smoking, like, fire. I feel like coming with fire, all that shit. And Elijah is my middle name, so, you know what I'm saying? Just do that in front of me.
Elijah Flame in the building. Like, I hope you make some hot shit.
Yeah, man. Come with the heat.
So right now we in Talkcast Studio, Phoenix, Arizona. We got Elijah Flame in the building. Naughty Kid behind me.
Think about, like, pretty much I have an idea for the song, so I'm kind of trying to keep it on topic with the song, but, like, also, like, personal experiences that I've been through and shit like that.
So personal experience, like what?
Shit, just been through a whole bunch of shit, like.
Come on, man, let's bring it up. So in your past, what made you become an artist in your personal experience?
I mean, I feel like I always had, like, music around, you know what I'm saying? Like, I wouldn't say it influenced me, but, like, no, like, music influenced me. I feel like it was my friends that influenced me to do music. But, you know what I'm saying? Just, like, being around music all the time, I always had a love for it. It was always, like, a connection to it that, like, I had. You know, I was, like, the kid that, like, people were, like, turn down your headphones, like, you're gonna go deaf type shit, all that.
So you say your friends influenced you. How did they influence you?
We were just, like, freestyling, you know what I'm saying? And, like, I would freestyle with my one homie. His name was Nick, and he was cold as fuck. He was, like, the one that really made me want to, like, take it seriously. Him and my other friend, Andre Vice, he still makes music, and, you know what I'm saying? We used to just freestyle all the time, all of us. Like, we used to just get together and freestyle. And those times just made me, like, really want to take it serious after all those times. I would say when we stopped doing it, that was when I was just like, I missed it. So I had to, like, I was like, I just gotta record something.
So do you put a lot of freestyling inside your music?
I honestly don't. That's, like, something I was about to, like start including more in, because I like the in the moment vibe of it, you know what I'm saying? I really get the feel of the song better instead of, like, coming off my phone and just, like, saying that and, like, the way I already put it down, you know, just, like, I could just think of new shit on the fly. You know, it might sound dope as fuck, but I could always change it. You know? It's just that, like, in the moment vibe is just, I feel like it's a whole different, whole better way to create.
So what do you think about these mumble rappers? They freestyle also, but you can't really understand them.
I mean, I feel like you can understand me. You know, I speak clearly in my songs, and I always try to bring something, like, you can understand. And, you know, most of the time, and it, like, I do try to make songs for everything. You know, like, songs that have like a message or songs for girls or, you know what I'm saying, songs for just like, just to go up to, you know, party to and shit. So I don't know, I feel like you can always understand me. But in the case of mumble rappers, you know, I don't hate on it, you know, whatever works for them, you know?
Elijah Flame in the building.
So what's your opinion?
Check
on
him out.
Rap and lyric beef.
They got the lyrical artists and you got the mumble rappers, they going head to head.
I just feel like it's a whole new scene coming in, and you know, the audience isn't really looking for lyrics as much anymore, so you know, the lyrical people can't really be mad, you know. And then if there is somebody that like does come through with the lyrics, you know, they really like, you notice like people with lyrics do get through. So you know, I feel like it's always going to be that audience, but you know, it's also a new audience out here right now, so you can't hate on it, you know.
So the new audience, what are they looking for?
I mean, I guess they're just looking for like that party like vibe, like I don't know, you know what I'm saying, that they're just trying to turn up. And like the slappers, banging beats.
So you think they look for like one hit wonders?
I don't know about that. Like there is, I don't know about that.
So doing music, what do you see yourself in 5 years?
Hopefully, you know, touring. I'm trying to just be doing shows. I'm really, just really trying to be my next step. I'm really hoping to be in a whole bunch of other stuff also, you know what I'm saying? Trying to create a little brand, like a little clothing brand. I'm trying to get shit popping with my group, all that. So 5 years, I probably see, you know what I'm saying, my group on a whole nother level. I haven't been like releasing music, so I see like myself, like this is gonna be like really like my freshman year, really. Like I'm about to start, you know what I'm saying, coming hard 2020. So I really feel like 5 years, like I should be like a vet in this bitch, you know what I'm saying?
So what's holding you back?
Nothing was really holding me back. I kind of just like was switched up everything, you know. I didn't really understand what I was doing, you know. I just really blew me. I liked making music, and you know, if it was only about making music, then like, you know, a whole bunch of people would have been on. But it's like really about figuring out like all the other things, you know, how I'm gonna put it out, how I'm gonna get other people to be interested in, like, to see it, really, you know, hear it. So it was really just like taking a step back, learning other things, and switching up my style, really. And I also changed my name too, so it was really just like a whole different transformation, coming back with a vengeance, you know what I'm saying?
So what was your name before?
I had a couple names. It was I think I started off with Young Pharaoh. Then it was Raph Goat. And I think Raph Goat.
So why do you think artists making that transition and changing their name?
I feel like when you first start doing music, if you don't, like a lot of people maybe might have a nickname, you know what I'm saying? I have a nickname, but like, it's like a family thing, you know? I don't really wanna like be called that. So I feel
what,
like-
What they call you? Come really, on, man, you gotta really tell us.
Maybe one day, but. So I feel like if you don't really come up with a nickname that you're being called like everywhere already, then you're gonna like have to make that like couple name switches because you don't really know who you really are as an artist yet.
Is it getting comfortable with yourself?
Yeah, definitely.
So what's the difference between you now as an artist and you when you first started?
I feel like I take more time on my music. I'm better at creating it now. Like, I know what I want to do with the song, you know what I'm saying? Before, I would just go on there and say a whole bunch of stuff and like, they, like, just feel like it sounded good, you know, like, just because it sounded good on that beat. But now, like, I'm better at like bringing my personal, you know, personal experience to it, and like better making it like about shit that's going on around me.
So you saying you from Phoenix, right?
Yeah.
So how was it growing up out here?
I mean, honestly, growing up out here it was pretty good for me personally, you know, like, it's, I started out, like, we just moved around a whole bunch of different places. My parents had me when they were young, so, like, started out, like, we were, like, you know, just kind of rough, but, like, eventually when I got to, like, I don't know, like, middle school, kind of, we moved out to, like, Goodyear, Litchfield area, and out there, I mean, it's pretty chill. I feel like in Arizona, it's, like, you have, like, a lot of chance to do, like, you could do a lot of things, but you just have to create your own opportunity. You can pretty much do whatever you want, but, you know, you have to create your own opportunity and really, like, find a way to make it big out here.
But can a lot of artists find that shine in Arizona?
Honestly, any artist can find the shine in Arizona. It's just, I don't know, it's just about, like, taking it over, you know. I don't have the shine right now in Arizona, but you know what I'm saying? When I do, I'll definitely not explain it.
So can you name one artist that has put Arizona on the map?
The only artist I heard of from Arizona was Futuristic, and I think Jordan Sparks from here too.
So can you say Futuristic put Arizona on the map? In the rap game?
I guess you can. I don't really know how. I don't really hear about Futuristic right now, you know. But I did. So I guess you can say that, because people didn't know him. He's pretty big.
So how long it took you to find your sound?
Still finding my sound. From like the day that I started making music, you know what I'm saying? Like, I feel like it's a bit more developed now. So I guess like when I felt more comfortable on recording, I felt like it was like maybe like a year and a half, 2 years, maybe I felt more comfortable recording, but like still like this long into it, I still feel like I'm still finding my sound. That's how I can feel, you know? I feel like a king, you know?
So if someone is willing to offer you a record deal, would you sign? If they drop 80 G's, said come work with us.
I mean, I don't know, it just depends, like, if everything's, like, as long as I'm not like getting trapped in anything, stuck in anything, I don't know, but I don't really know. I guess I would have to know what they could do for me, you know what I'm saying? Like, is it just like they're just gonna give me $80,000 and then that's it, you know what I'm saying? And then the person that I started freestyling with, or all the people that I started freestyling with, so mainly one of them was my homie Nick Kirker. Then another one is Jiggy James. He's also another artist. He used to be my neighbor. He actually like was a big part in helping me develop my sound. He's like basically one of my main producers. And he worked with me basically till I felt comfortable coming to studios like this and shit. Like, I was working with him inside of his house.
So what made you feel comfortable? Like, how does that work?
Pretty much just like writing, like just making a whole bunch of songs and like really like liking my voice. I really liked hearing my voice, and I really liked the way the songs were coming out. So I knew like if the songs that I kept making were coming out like good, then while I'm recording it, like I shouldn't feel like insecure or anything. Like I should just know, like I know I'm just making a good song. Like I know I'm just making a song. Like it's not really a big deal.
How many sessions you book in the studio to make one song?
To make one song, I mean, I usually make a song like when I write, I'll usually make the song like in an hour. Cause I already have it written, so I'll just go in there and just spit it all. But I'm about to see how long it really, cause working with my homie like at his house, I guess we could like chop it up and really make songs different like that. So it'll take a little while. Well, usually like maybe like a week, we'll have like a song, we can like make a song with our group. It's usually like that, like a week. So like that's the only times like that we really started a song and finished it without just writing it, just sitting there writing it all and just like finishing it. But if I sit there and write it, it'll probably take me like 2 hours to, maybe like writing it, it'll take like an hour. Then I'll come knock it out in like an hour.
So you're saying you in a group? What kind of group is it?
I would say it's like a pop R&B type group. It's honestly not. It's like a rap group too. It's really everything. Like it's really just a whole different sound, I would say. It's called Good Off Days. We already have an album out actually. And we're working on the second one right now. And I mean, it's really just like a whole different sound. I would just say it's like, I would really explain it more as pop, but or like R&B, but it's also still rap.
Rap, like how Juice WRLD and everybody else is making?
Nah, not at all. I would say it's like old. I would say it's kind of like old, like 2009, maybe like T-Pain, a little bit of like, I don't know, like it just like really just like kind of like vibe, like really a vibe, really just like bringing vibes, you know? But it's not like, I would just really say it's more like, more based on like that era though, you know, like 2009 maybe, that type of vibe. And the new wave like category, you know, like the type of rappers that you see coming out today, but like I really just make a whole bunch of different type of songs. I don't really try to make like one type of song, you know, but I do like try to come with the hard beats for the most part, but I'll try to like, I'll also like, you know, I'll sing on them and shit, you know what I'm saying? So I would say it's just like, it's like a feel good type of style.
Would you say is your twin, as in lyrics?
As in lyrics, I mean.
Like when people hear your music, like, damn, bro, you sound like so-and-so.
I've heard Travis Scott. I've heard Ski Mask. I've heard, I heard like a weird one that said like D Herbo vibes or something like that, like comments on my shit, just like some weird shit, you know what I'm saying? All those were like comments on my music.
So how do you get your views up on social media?
Now it's just really just posting snippets. I've been posting a lot of snippets and letting people know like I got music coming. So like basically I've been posting a whole bunch of snippets. They know I got heaters on the way. So I feel like that's like building up a little bit, you know what I'm saying? And I'm really about to like do like a promotion and everything, you know, get myself really out there on Instagram, just really just show them, make videos and really show them like me, you know what I'm saying? I feel like they need to see as well as hear, and that'll like really bring the eyes and ears. The internet, it's just really, you could just really send it directly to everybody, you know what I'm saying? You just really have to do all the groundwork and just as to like extra promoting to get it to new people that don't know you already. You know, you have to do that your own, but you really don't need the companies. The companies, like, really probably would just help it and take a lot of stress off of you so you could just be focused on music.
So you have anything dropping in tune anytime soon? Tell the people that where they can see that at.
So pretty soon I'm about to be dropping Switch music video. Probably gonna come with another music video after that. Don't know if it's gonna be between two. Probably gonna have like people, just the fans decide that and post it on my Instagram. You can follow me on Instagram at It's Elijah Baby. You know what I'm saying? SoundCloud, It's Elijah Baby. Got nothing. I'm about to drop some shit on there. I'll probably drop some shit on there. 2 weeks from the interview dropping, I'll drop a song. You know what I'm saying? I'll drop a song. Might have a music video coming 2 weeks later. Then just keep coming month after month with new content. I'm just keep coming content.
So how do you connect the title with a song?
I feel like once you come up with the idea of the song and which direction you're kind of taking it, you could really come up with a song. Like, the chorus might have it in it sometimes, you know what I'm saying? It's just a whole bunch of different things, really, that could, like, make you come up with a title for a song or even a project. You know, I feel like the best, or, like, you could really get the whole thing when it's done and you listen to it a couple of times and you get like, all right, this is the name. But like the ones that come to you like that, those are also the good ones. You know what I'm saying? It's just a whole bunch of different ways you can come up with titles. So that's honestly a fun part of creating the song, you know, a little easy.
So if you were to go back in the past as the wisdom you have today, what would you do differently?
Honestly, I would stop myself from doing like stupid stuff, you know what I'm saying? Like
what?
I was like, you know what I'm saying? Like when I ain't have no money, you know what I'm saying? Just prevent myself from doing stupid stuff and just, you know what I'm saying? Just doing stupid stuff that I didn't really need to do, you know what I'm saying? I would just tell myself, just stay straight, you know what I'm saying? Just focus. Cause I really stopped music and was just not focused. I was like playing with it. I would just tell myself focus, you know what I'm saying? Just really focus on this shit and just go hard. If I would have focused, I probably would have, who knows where I would have been, you know, just really focus.
High school?
I started music at the end of high school, but I was like, really the time, cause you know, that's when no one really knows what to do, you know, and you see people going to college. I was not about to do that, you know. You can just go get a job or whatever. It was just like a whole bunch of different stuff going on. You see a whole bunch of people doing different stuff. And like we just had started rapping, just had found it. So I dropped this song. And it low-key went up. Like, it was, like, right at the end of the year, I dropped a song, it low-key went up. Like, for me, I felt
what
like
was the name of the song?
It was called Drop. And I felt like, I don't know, after that shit, when I felt, like, all the connection to, like, everybody, like, fucking with the song and, like, fucking with something that I created, like, just that feeling. I just wanted to like get that feeling more and more, like bigger and bigger, you know what I'm saying? So
in your high school, on your social media account, do they really show any love to you?
Some show love. It's like some will show love, you know, and they really hear or see something, like they see something different. They really like have to see. But like I'll see some show love like from the shadows, you know, I'll see like them in the likes or anything, but like I don't see them, like they don't tell me nothing, but like, you know, it's just like whatever, you know.
So do that affect an artist when they see people they know not really showing them any love?
I mean it used to, but at this point nah, because I know like those people like should fuck with me because they do know me, but you know, I just feel like there's also millions of people in the world. So like, if they don't fuck with me, it's not like the end of the world, because like so-and-so from, you know, whatever could fuck with me, so.
But do you think that's the hardest thing as an artist, to try to get...
To try and get people from like around you?
Yeah.
Yeah, I feel like that is, that's a hard thing, you know? That's a definitely hard thing, because I don't know why, I don't know what it is about, like, when they see, when they don't see you, like, already up, and, like, they see you trying to, like, promote yourself. I don't know what it is, like, they don't want to believe yet or something like that. They don't believe, or it's just something is holding them back from really wanting to show you love. I don't know what it is, but, you know what I'm saying? I guess that is a real hard thing to do.
Like, you always get that conversation of like, you make music now? How's that going?
Honestly, I get the conversation now, like, you still making music a lot. Like, they ask me, like, I'll run into somebody, you still making music? Like, yeah, like, check my shit out, you know what I'm saying? And then it's just like, never really like hear about them or anything like that again, hear from them again, but that's really the conversation now. So follow me on Instagram for sure. It's Elijah Baby. Go check out the Good Off Days project. It's on Apple Music. It's honestly everywhere. Go check that out. Just type in Good Off Days. You can go find that. A little glimpse into me. It's a whole different vibe. It's me and my group. Andre Vice, Jiggy James. He also produced everything on there. We also got another member in there. His name is Imari. He's another producer that we just added in the group right now. We're working on this new album all together, so Good Off Days, go check that out. You know what I'm saying? We're gonna have social media coming soon for that. You know what I'm saying? Shouts out everybody that fucks with me for real. Royal Life Productions.